Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hello students, I welcome you to our online teaching academy Ekalaiva. Today for your English class we are going to continue our lesson The Stalled Ox. The Stalled Ox by Sakhi part 2. Just a small recap of the first part for you children. An ox enters the garden of Adela Pingsford. She approaches her neighbor, artist Ashley, to help her out to drive the ox away. Ashley is an artist who specializes in painting pictures of cows. Ashley now comes to help Adela. Let's see how Ashley is going to help Adela to drive the ox out of the house. Now Ashley is at Adela's place. Let's see what happens at Adela's place. Ashley stood very near the gate while he studied the animal's appearance and behavior. Adela Pingsford continued to say nothing. Now the ox was a very huge animal and Ashley was quite scared to chase it away. It looked quite dangerous. So he was standing and watching the behavior and appearance of the animal. He didn't know what to do. He was also helpless. "It's eating a flower," said Ashley at last. Then Ashley at last spoke. He said, it's eating a flower. The ox is eating a flower." "How clever you are," said Adela. "You seem to notice everything. As a matter of fact, it has got 6 flowers in its mouth at the present moment." Now Adela is getting very irritated. She is trying to mock Ashley. She is saying, "You're very clever. You seem to notice everything." Now the ox is not having just 1 flower. It's having 6 flowers in its mouth. The ox moves. Something had to be done. Ashley took a step or two in the direction of the animal, clapped his hands and made noises like hish and shoo. If the ox heard them, it seemed to take no notice. So Ashley also made his attempt to chase away the ox. He clapped his hands and made sounds like shoo and hish, and he tried to chase it away. But it was of no use. The ox did not move at all. "If any hens should ever wander into my garden," said Adela, "I shall certainly come and ask you to frighten them out. You shoo beautifully. Meanwhile, do you mind trying to drive that ox away?" Now Adela is getting impatient with Ashley. She is trying to make fun of his attempt. She says that if any hens come into my garden, I'll definitely call you to chase them away. "You shoo very beautifully, but do you mind trying to drive that ox away? Will you do something to drive that ox away?" She is asking Ashley. "That is my best rose bush that he has begun to eat now," she added in a calm but icy voice, as a beautiful orange colored rose was crushed into the huge mouth. Adela is saying that this ox is now starting to eat my best rose bush, and in that time the ox is chewing the beautiful rose flower. Then Adela Pingsford's patience and icy calmness broke down. The language she used sent the artist a few feet nearer to the ox. Then Adela is getting even more impatient, and now she is sounding a bit harsh to Ashley. She is very keen to drive that ox away because the ox is spoiling her beautiful garden. So she says him to drive the ox away, and Ashley tries to move towards the ox. He picked up a thin stick and flung it against the animal's legs. So Ashley picked up a stick and threw it at the animal's leg. Flung means throw. He just threw it at the animal's leg. For a long time, the ox stopped turning the roses into lunch. For some time, the ox stopped eating the roses. By that time, the ox was making all her roses into its lunch. For some time it was just standing there watching Ashley and Adela. While it looked with great interest at the stick thrower, Adela glared with equal interest and more obvious anger at the same person. Now, the ox looked at Ashley with interest. It was looking at him keenly because he is trying to make it move. Now, Adela is also staring at Ashley with anger because she is very angry that Ashley is not trying to do anything properly to chase that ox away. Here, glared means stared, stare with anger. Obvious means it is clearly seen, it is very clearly seen. So now both Ashley, Adela and the ox are in a fix. Now both the ox and Adela are staring at Ashley. Let's see what Ashley is going to do next. As the animal neither lowered its head nor stamped its feet, Ashley tried throwing another stick. Now the ox didn't try to harm them or do anything. He didn't try to lower its head or just stamp its feet and didn't make any attempt to try to attack them. So Ashley was a bit confident now that he will be able to chase the ox. So Ashley tried throwing another stick. He picked up another stick and he threw it at the ox. The ox seemed to realize at once that it was being asked to move. So the ox immediately understood that they are asking it to move. It is being asked to move out of the garden. It gave a hurried final bite to the flowers and walked quickly up the garden. It hurriedly ate up the flowers and walked up the garden. Ashley ran to turn it back towards the gate. What did Ashley do? He just ran towards the ox to turn it towards the gate to make it go out, to make it move out of the house, but only succeeded in making it walk faster in the opposite direction. But unfortunately, the ox started walking in the opposite direction. That is, the ox started walking towards the house. It didn't walk towards the gate to move out. It started walking towards the house. Soon, it had crossed a small area of grass between the garden and house and pushed its way through the open French doors into the morning room. So, what the ox did, I told you, the ox started walking in the opposite direction towards the house. There, it saw the French doors open and it pushed its way into the morning room. It entered the morning room of Adela's house. Now, French doors means you can see it in the picture. It is just a small door which leads you to the garden from the morning room. It's a small window. It's a window which will lead you to the morning room. Now, some flowers stood in vases around the room and the animal continued its lunch. Now, the ox has entered Adela Pinksford's morning room through the French windows and it saw some flowers in the vases and it started continuing its lunch happily. Meanwhile, Ashley imagined that a slightly dangerous look had come into his eyes. So, Ashley observed that the ox has now become quite serious. It doesn't want to be disturbed. So, when Ashley observed it, he thought of another plan. He stopped trying to make it go where it did not want to go. So, Ashley did not try to disturb it at all. He just kept quiet. He didn't want to disturb the ox because the ox appeared to be dangerous now. This is our second part. Now we will see how Ashley is going to chase away the ox from the morning room of Adela Pinksford and what is going to happen in the next part. Thank you. To receive our online lessons, please press the subscribe button and you will receive the latest updates. Thank you very much.